This is a plastinated specimen of the liver. You will notice the bulky size of the liver and the wedge shape of the liver. The liver has a diaphragmatic surface and a visceral surface. Anatomically, the liver has two lobes, the right lobe of the liver and the left lobe of the liver. And the demarcation between these two lobes of the liver is the attachment of the falciform ligament. This is the attachment of the falciform ligament. In the free border, lower border of the falciform ligament, you can see here that there is a thickening, which is called the ligamentum teres hepatis, and this represents the obliterated left umbilical vein. On the visceral surface of the liver, there are impressions that are produced by the viscera which are related to the liver. On the left side, this impression is produced by the stomach. The gastric impression continues into an impression of the duodenum, the first part of the duodenum. And on the right side, there is another impression which is related to the colon, that is the right colic flexure or the hepatic flexure of the colon. Just above that is an impression which is related to the right kidney. And above that, the impression here is related to the right suprarenal gland. On the visceral surface of the liver, you can notice that there is a capital H shape arrangement, two vertical bars and a horizontal bar. The vertical bar here is formed by a fissure for the ligamentum teres and another fissure above it, the fissure for the ligamentum venosum. On the right side, the right bar is formed by the inferior vena cava, which grooves the liver, and by the gallbladder. The horizontal bar is formed by the porta hepatis, where structures pass in and out of the liver. The gallbladder, as you can see it here, is attached to the visceral surface of the liver. It has a fundus, a body, and neck that leads to the cystic duct. Here, this is the portal vein, which is passing into the porta hepatis of the liver. The falciform ligament, as it approaches the liver, it will split into two leaves, a right leaf and a left leaf. The left leaf of the falciform ligament will fold around itself and form the left triangular ligament. This is the left triangular ligament, which attaches the left lobe of the liver to the diaphragm. On the right side, the right leaf of the falciform ligament forms the upper coronary ligament, and this is separated from the lower part of the coronary ligament here by a wide area that is not covered by peritoneum, and this is called the bare area of the liver. So this is the region of the bare area of the liver. The inferior vena cava grooves the liver and then appears upwards to pass through the central tendon of the diaphragm. During its grooving of the liver, it receives the hepatic veins. The hepatic veins, they drain into the inferior vena cava as it grooves the liver, and thus they have no extrahepatic course. You can see the openings here of the hepatic veins draining into the inferior vena cava as the inferior vena cava passes within a groove in the liver. Returning back to the visceral surface of the liver, you will notice two lobes, two other lobes, and this is the caudate lobe of the liver, and this one is the quadrate lobe of the liver. The caudate lobe of the liver is located between the groove for the inferior vena cava and the fissure for the ligamentum venosum, and it has a cephalic position. Nevertheless, it is called the caudate lobe because it has a process here, a tail. This is the caudate process. So the caudate lobe is located above the porta hepatis. Below the porta hepatis, you will notice the quadrate lobe, which has a quadrangular shape. It is located below the porta hepatis, in between the fissure for the ligamentum teres and the groove that lodges the gallbladder. The caudate lobe and the quadrate lobe functionally are considered part of the left lobe of the liver, although anatomically speaking, they look like as if they belong to the right lobe of the liver.